Guys, we have seen so many comments on our build videos here recently of you asking how to get certain mods. These are mods that are directly tied to our builds, and I know we have new players in this game as well. So today we've gathered all the information in one place on how to get every single mod in Destiny 2. And this includes, of course, the sources for these mods, what each category of mods does for you, some general tips, and at the end, I do want to touch on some of my personal favorite mods that you should keep an eye out for. Now first, you can view every single mod in the game if you head over to your collections tab and select mods. If you want to follow along with us in game so you can view all the mods yourself or look at them in more detail as we're talking about them, we'll actually be starting with the ghost mods, which is the rightmost selection in the mods page. Then we'll move to weapons, then armor. So let's kick it off. Starting with our ghost mods, these mods offer multiple different benefits, from increase in XP gains, which are very good to have at the beginning of a season or when you're turning in bounties. Most XP mods are unlocked by default. Also, some of these mods help you locate resources and chests on planets. Some give you increased glimmer gains, higher stats on armor, or increased chances of specific materials from specific playlists. Some are unlocked by default, and some are found via legendary world engrams. Now, playlist-specific mods are found via engrams obtained through those playlists via their respective vendors. Vanguard Ghost mods come from engrams obtained at Zavala. Gambit Ghost mods come from engrams obtained at the Drifter, where Crucible Ghost mods come from engrams obtained at Shax. Now, this takes us to weapon mods. These mods are slotted directly onto your weapons, and they can directly impact how much damage your weapon deals to certain enemies. They also offer up weapon bonuses or increase the duration and effectiveness of certain perks on your weapons. Most are only obtained from Banshee, who is the gunsmith. I know most of my veteran players already know all of this stuff, but again, we're targeting people that don't even know what the hell these mods are. Now, through the gunsmith, this can be obtained via the 4 weapon mods he sells every day, and these mods reset every day at the daily reset, or via the engrams you get from ranking up. The fastest way to rank up Banshee is just to do the daily gunsmith bounties, which are actually very easy. You can also earn very small amounts of Banshee rep when you dismantle legendary weapons. Now, let's move into some of the more specific mods. Taken Spec. This is a very beneficial mod when dealing with Taken, and it can only be obtained from Last Wish Raid completions. It gives you an increased damage against Taken enemies, and even in Nightfalls, like Lake of Shadows, or even the Corrupted, this is a great mod to have. Sweaty Confetti can only be obtained from Xur's Treasure Hoard in Eternity, which you can open using treasure keys obtained from Dares of Eternity. This mod is simply a fun cosmetic thing that causes festive celebration on each precision final blow. If y'all remember back in Halo Reach, we had this as an upgrade for our Spartans. Adept Weapon Mods. Now, these are special mods that give you plus 10 to an individual weapon stat, amongst other benefits. You have a chance to obtain them from Grandmaster Nightfall completions, and this is by far the best way to farm for Adept mods, as you keep getting rewards from these strikes when you complete them. You're also guaranteed one drop from the Flawless Chest via Trials of Osiris. However, Adept Icarus can only drop from the Flawless Chest. Now, there is a chance to obtain via encounters in things like Master Raids, Vault of Glass, Vow of Disciple, King's Fall. Each of the main encounters have a chance to drop an Adept mod, but these are weekly chances. So if you have 3 characters, then you have 15 chances to get a drop spread out across those raids. Now, I do want to note here that these raids drop Adept mods because they have their own version of Adept weapons. Vault of Glass Adept weapons are actually called Time Loss. Vow of the Disciple weapons are still called Adept, and King's Fall Adept weapons are called Harrowed. Now, there's really not a whole lot of benefit going for Adept weapons from these raids versus the craftable versions, but in the most recent TWAB, it was mentioned that Adept weapons for raids are going to be getting an upgrade. So think like enhanced perks and maybe even enhanced perks dropping. Now, you can also have a chance to get these Adept mods via Master Grasp of Avarice, and there is also a chance to obtain it via Master Duality. However, I have no confirmation on that, so we might be lying to you. Let me know in the comments below if an Adept mod is ever dropped for you for Master Duality. Now, armor mods. There is an absolute ton of these, and they will take the longest for you to acquire in terms of collecting them all. Now, unless you've been playing D2 since the beginning or close to it, you're likely missing quite a few of these. The newer you are, the more mods you probably don't have because of the sheer amount of them. First, we're going to go over each category of armor mods, then we'll talk about how you can get them. Helmet armor mods. This includes weapon ammo finder mods. This actually increases the chances of finding certain ammo type when you have a specific weapon equipped. Weapon targeting mods. This actually improves the aim down sight speed, accuracy, and target acquisition of a specific weapon type. This greatly benefits target acquisition inside of things like PvP. Siphon mods. These help you generate orbs of power on certain kinds of elemental rapid kills. Super assist mods. These increase your super regeneration, and it also grants super energy or generates more orbs when you use your super. And essentially all of these mods have specific ways to activate these benefits. Now, armor mods. This includes your weapon loader mods, which increases the reload speed of a specific weapon. You have dexterity mods, which increases the readiness stow speed of a specific weapon type. And then you have grenade ability transfer and kickstart mods. Now, ability transfer mods allow allows you to generate energy for an ability by using a different ability. The fastball mod is also found here, which increases your grenade throw distance. We're hoping this is going to become something intrinsic or default for grenade throws in the future, and Bungie can get rid of this mod. And kickstart mods gives you energy for an ability when you fully expend that same ability energy. Now, chest mods includes weapon reserve mods, which increases the amount of ammo you can carry for a certain weapon type, weapon unflinching mod, which reduces flinch from incoming fire while aiming certain weapons, and then damage resist mods. These actually increase your damage resist from certain sources: arc, solar, void, stasis, sniper, melee, and area of effect. Now, leg mods include weapon scavenger mods. These give bonus ammo reserves when picking up ammo for a specific weapon type from the ground. Weapon holster mods, these actually reload a specific stowed weapon type over time. And then orb of power mods are mods that activate upon picking up an orb of power. Some generate ability energy, some actually generate health. No lie, super clutch on orb pickups for staying alive, especially in like day one raids or even GMs. Now, class mods. Class ability mods help you get your class ability back faster upon doing certain things or using other abilities. You also have finisher mods present on your class item, which gives you benefits when using your finisher on enemies. But each time they're used, it does consume an amount of super energy, which changes depending on the mod. Now, all head, arm, chest, leg, and class mods can be found by opening legendary engrams or by vendor rank ups, including the Vanguard, Crucible, Gambit, and the Gunsmith. The only mod here that you can't get from these sources is special finisher, which for some reason you can only get from Ada 1, who is present in the annex. General mods. These mods give boost to your character stats, which include mobility, discipline, intellect, recovery, strength, and resilience. Now, there are two types of each of these mods, minor and regular. Minor stat mods are unlocked by default and give a +5 to the corresponding stats. The regular version of the mods are found via opening legendary engrams and vendor rank-up packages. Now, the fact that you don't get these +10 versions of these armor mods by default is actually really dumb, because they help out a lot and they really tie a lot of builds together when reaching those max stats. Which takes us to combat style mods. These contain a wide assortment of different mods and are the building blocks to build crafting in Destiny. Now, these are the mods that people normally want. There's 71 of them. Just about every one of our build videos includes them. And there's been different evolutions to these mods. We have War Mod Cells for the longest time. That was like the most powerful of all the mods, but of course they got nerfed. Charged with Light became a thing. That was the most powerful. And then we progressed to Elemental Wells. We kind of fluctuate between Elemental Wells and Charged with Light. War Mod Cells, although I do still love them, they're not nearly as potent as they once were. And on top of that, nothing in Bungie's artifacts season to season really benefits War Mod Cells. Whereas back in the day, we used to have things like Tyrant Surge, which would actually benefit you when utilizing War Mod Cell builds. All of these mods are actually only obtainable through Ada 1 in the tower. She sells 4 a day, and these also reset at the daily reset. Now, if you don't want to log in every day to check her mods, you can use apps like the Destiny Companion app, which actually allows you to view all the vendors and what they're selling that day. Now, the process of obtaining these combat style mods is honestly the most annoying thing here, as the only source is Ada 1. And this is a major pain point in the Destiny community, because it's just another huge hurdle that New Light players and any new player in general who have to overcome it via just luck. Sometimes you have to wait weeks or even months for certain mods to come back around. Now, I know that inside of the collections tab, some of these combat style mods state that you can obtain them through the war table or splice servitor, wayfinder's compass, and other random items that you may not recognize. Now, these mods were introduced as part of a previous season and were obtained through unique vendors, but now they can be obtained from Ada 1, even though it doesn't say it in game. But the vast majority of these other mods, and the ones we utilize as much as we do, can only be obtained through Ada, which is our segue right now into saying, hey, Bungie, please just open up a store so everyone can have access to these mods. Nothing kills a build faster than not having access to Explosive Wellmaker or Elemental Ordnance or even Seeking Wells and a number of other mods that is quite necessary for these builds. Now, moving on to raid mods. These are mods you obtain via raids, and most of them only benefit you while you're specifically in the raid. Some of these are actually really, really good. And I think once we get to a point where Master Raid is going to be a rotation people hit every single week, you're going to see people using raid mods more. Now, seasonal mods. These are mods you're going to find as part of the seasonal artifact, and they are a big part of how the sandbox shifts every season. As when a new season begins, the previous season's mods go away. Now, we have definitely had some standout mods, even most recently, like Classy Restoration. But in the past, things like Energy Accelerant, Tyrant Surge was one we mentioned earlier. These were seasonal defining artifact mods. They make a huge difference when it comes to these builds, survivability, and your overall lethality season to season. Now, these mods are solely unlocked through gaining experience. And while you're viewing the current season artifacts, you're able to see how far you are away from your next mod mod unlock. You're also able to unlock whatever mods you want in any order, as long as you have the specific column unlocked. Now, these columns actually unlock when you've unlocked a certain amount of mods in the previous columns. Back in the day, you would only have a certain amount of mods you can actually unlock. And every time you would actually want to use a mod that you haven't unlocked, you would actually have to reset your artifact, which was extremely expensive. Now, the most powerful of these mods are often found in the final column, and they usually offer up benefits that are staples for builds. The seasonal mods are also where you're gonna find the current season's champion mods. Now, these mods provide specific weapon types the ability to stun one of three champion types in the game, which include Overload, Unstoppable, and Barrier. And if you're actually gonna be playing in-game PvE content, you need to become familiar with those three champion types. Now, weapon-related versions of these champion mods can only be slotted in your arms, but the ability-related version champion mods can actually be slotted in your class item. Now, something to note for my new players out there, you will never see a mod you already have drop again. There's essentially a knockout system in place for mods, so once you have the mod once, you have it for good across all your characters, and you'll never have to have it drop again. Now, a few mod recommendation and mods to look out for. The plus 10 stat mods are really good and help you reach tier 10 or 100 on your stats. In a world where resilience is king right now and you don't want to be caught below max, these mods are very good. Also, Ashes to Assets is a great mod and requires almost no setup. It grants you bonus super energy on grenade kills, and considering we now have tiers for our supers and overall a lot of our potent supers take longer to get, things like Ashes to Assets really helps here. Many of our 3.0 builds utilize Ashes to Assets. Ammo finder mods, especially heavy weapon versions, will help you get heavy drops, which are often needed for harder content. Same with heavy weapon scavenger mods. But as far as the combat style mods that I would definitely look out for that are pretty much utilized in all of our builds include Taking Charge, High Energy Fire, Powerful Friends, Protective Light, Energy Converter, Elemental Ordnance, Font of Might, Well of Life, Reaping Wellmaker, Well of Tenacity, Melee Wellmaker, Elemental Charge, Bountiful Wells. I'm not saying that these other mods aren't good, but those are the mods we are constantly taking advantage of in this current sandbox. There's still a ton of other ones that are very useful outside of maybe like War Mod Cells. Cross, are any of these mods useful for PvP? Actually, yeah. When you take into account things like Powerful Friends or Radiant Light, these mods actually have secondary benefits. And a lot of these mods actually have secondary benefits. Radiant actually gives you plus 20 in strength. Powerful Friends gives you plus 20 in mobility. And these are just ways in which you can top off those stats. But even outside of that, I take advantage of things like Quick Charge, which greatly increases the ready speed for fusion rifles, shotguns, submachine guns, and swords. And again, all you have to do is satisfy its secondary requirements, which is either A, equip an arc mod on that single piece that you have that mod with, or B, you can just rock one of these arc-related mods on another armor piece in that same combat armor mod slot. And this would actually satisfy the requirement for both of these. So for example, if I wanted to rock Powerful Friends and Radiant Light, I would just have two arc affinity pieces, rock both of those, and they both will satisfy that arc requirement, granting me those secondary stats. And this applies to other things. On top of that, High Energy Fire gives you a nice little bump there in damage. And considering you're going to be picking up orbs at different points inside of a PvP match, having things like Taking Charge will grant you High Energy Fire, thus allowing you to sometimes break TTK values and get kills even faster. And if your friends are rocking things like Powerful Friends and Radiant Light, when they pop their supers or when they become charged with light, you too will become charged with light. So I highly advise taking advantage of charged with light inside of PvP. So guys, that is the mod breakdown or mods breakdown for my new light players and any new players to Destiny. I hope this video helps you. Again, read through all of these, especially these combat style mods. Some of them have secondary requirements that offers more benefits than what's on just the face of the mod. But these are mods that definitely change the game. They make builds what they are. I remember back in the day, we used to just have builds that would just be an exotic and our subclass, and that's it. And we called that a build. Nah, man, this is what makes builds, builds in Destiny. This changes the game. And the sooner you get these mods, the sooner Destiny really starts to open up for you. Hopefully, Bungie is going to make these mods easier to obtain. And I think we just need to have a store from Ada with every single mod and you can just purchase all of them. Guys, if I missed anything in this video, feel free to comment down below. And big shout out to the team, aka Jarrett, for collecting all this information. This was fantastic. Fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.